Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today we're here with another review. Today we're gonna have a look at the Papo Pteranodon figure. It's another pterosaur from Papo dinosaur line. As you can see right here on the catalog, his product code is 55006. Nice looking Pteranodon. It can't stand on his own, so you need to hang it somehow from a tree or something like that. So let's remove this Papo label from his feet and have a closer look on the figure. This one reminds me the one that we saw in the Jurassic Park movie. I think this resembles this one, and it does it pretty well. If you can actually place it on somehow on a tree, you know, with his feet like that, I think it would be okay. Yeah, it's a very nice looking Pteranodon. I really like this figure a lot. You can actually hang it from somewhere and have it on the shelf hanged above the others. It has this nice, you know, flying pose. So yeah, let's have a look on the eye. You can see it has this black spot all around it, and inside it's the yellow eye. And I think that this gives the figure a more menacing look. The plastic on the head is actually pretty, you know, bendy. You can see it's not that hard of a plastic. You can squeeze it, as you can see. Something that I really like. You don't have to worry about breaking or something like that. The same in the wings too, as you can see, or even the legs. And let's see the mouth. As you can see, the mouth they have painted and the teeth white. And it's not they are very nicely painted. You don't see any sloppiness at all on the down part of the jaw. They are very small teeth too, so very nice job from Papo to this one. And here is around the eye, it has some brown spots and this entire black coloration that it ends up right here to his body, which is the same, which is black too, you know. It has some brownish spots right here on the feet, but the end are still black. You can see the claws are pretty okay. And you can see all these details that they have put very nicely on his wings. You can see so much details going on all the way. And how from this dark brownish coloration they go to this lighter variation of brown, and then it ends up to this gray black coloration, the same to this one. So yeah, like I said, Papo usually gives this figure these naturalistic colors, very earth-like coloration. And here is the body of the Pteranodon. You can see the chest area right here, the shoulders, the ribs of the figure, very nicely sculpted, and there's some sort of a small tail right here. Yeah, very cool figure. Now let's see how he scales with some other pterosaurs of the Papo line. Here we have the Papo Tupuhuara. Hope I pronounced it right. And here is the Papo Dimetrodon. There you go. And also the Papo Archaeopteryx. You can see, I really like Papo, you know, making a lot different species, you know, from dinosaurs. I would love to see them producing more flying dinosaur species, you know. So I think that, yeah, I like all of them. They scale pretty nice next to each other. Really glad for actually could add this Pteranodon to my collection. The only different part is that even though he is on this flying position, he cannot stand like the rest of these pterosaurs, because I like when make pterosaurs on this flying on this position that you can actually stand it somehow and place it. It would be cool if they have done it with this with the Pteranodon, because it's the most common and well-known pterosaur. So if they could somehow make it be, you know, on this flying position and stand at the same time, I thought it would be okay, you know, something like this, you know, that you could actually have it flying and standing. I think it would be okay, but yeah, it is what it is. So this was, guys, the Papo Pteranodon figure from the Papo dinosaur line. Thanks for watching the video, hope you enjoyed it and I helped you out. I'm gonna see you next time. Bye.